Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. As anticipated, we had some stronger seismic activity following the critical planetary geometry on the 7th, as you can see a magnitude 5.8, 5.9 at the southern East Pacific rise, that is west of South America, west of Chile. It's the only stronger seismic event, so we did not have a clustering this time. And as you can see, it very much depends on the condition of Earth's crust, exactly how the seismic response will be to the planetary geometry. If you look further on the SGI graph, we have quite some critical planetary geometry coming up this week. Today and tomorrow, two planetary conjunctions. If we look at the solar system, we see Earth, Sun and Uranus in a conjunction that will be later today. And it will be followed by a critical planetary conjunction tomorrow, and that will be Mercury, Venus and Mars. And that combination can prove quite critical. We could have a strong to major seismic event around the 11th, most likely, give or take one day. So this could be as early as tomorrow. Back to the SGI graph, we also see critical planetary geometry coming up later this week, and it will be on the 13th and 14th, including a planetary conjunction. And that will be Venus, Sun and Neptune, which will be a critical one. But I would like to focus on the geometry that we're going to have on the 13th and 14th. These are the dashed peaks, and that indicates 90 degree angles, purple and red, involving Mercury and Venus. So let's have a look at the solar system again. On the 13th, we have a 90 degree angle of Venus with Mercury and Uranus. And that's a critical one. And usually they come in pairs because Venus is close to Mercury and they are close to the Sun and the outer planets are far away. And indeed, on the 14th, we have also a 90 degree angle, and that is Mercury with Venus and Uranus. The last time that this planetary geometry occurred was in January, and it was followed by a magnitude 7.6 earthquake. Before then, in September last year, the same planetary geometry was also followed by a mid-7 magnitude earthquake. So as you can see, this geometry can be very critical. And we could see a major seismic event around mid-7 magnitude based on this geometry alone. And as you can see also, we have Venus, Sun and Neptune in a conjunction, and that comes on top of the critical geometry. So this is going to be a critical week. We could see strong to major seismic activity, possibly one or two magnitude 7 earthquakes. If we look at this planetary geometry on the 13th and 14th, we could see the largest seismic activity around the 15th, give or take one day. There could be 14th, 15th or 16th. It could also be on the 17th. If you look at the SGI graph again, we have a higher lunar peak on the 17th. So if it arrives late, that is also a possibility. In any case, if you are in an earthquake-prone area, be on watch this week. It is going to be critical and it could be strong to major seismic activity. I cannot say exactly where this is going to be. On the website, we have atmospheric fluctuations and they are updated regularly and they may give us an indication where the larger seismic activity can occur. But this is a rough estimate, so if you are in an earthquake-prone area, be on extra alert, have an earthquake plan. This is very important. Stay safe. Until next time.